Our favourite project right now, and apart from the one in Blackburn, is a project called Dreamland in Margate. And, you know, it will become, and it is at the moment, one of the most talked about regeneration schemes in the UK. It's always on the One Show, and it's being championed by all sorts of big names. But Dreamland wouldn't be happening if already a creative community hadn't been forced out of London, chose to leave London, to go into an area that was the south coast equivalent of the Mitty district, higher deprivation levels than northeast Lancashire, which is surprising. I think it's slightly higher drug issues than Blackburn, which I think Blackburn's fourth in the country. I think Margate was third at the stage. But what people like us saw was an opportunity. The opportunity was 5-bedroom houses on the seafront for 250,000 when you can't even buy a shoebox in, well, you cannot buy a 1-bedroom flat in London for 250. You can't buy one for 350 at the moment in a London postcode. Believe it or not, you can't buy one a single. So people were thinking, there's an opportunity here. It's an hour and a half from a major conurbation. It's got streets that we can take, and they've taken it. And now, you know, what is happening in Margate is what the government has been trying to make happen. There's been the Porteous pilot. There's been all sorts of money poured into that town. But what's making it happen? We're making it happen. And I also want to talk a bit about generosity. What we are capable of as a community, I would say that creative minds and creative people are a very generous set of people. I think you'll find that you'll do things for community, for community interest groups, that maybe other people in other sectors wouldn't do. How many people here take on projects that really yield very little profit? Just about everybody. And you do it because that's the kind of person that you are. And we can change the world. And around the world, there are amazing examples of the world being changed by, you know, creative designers. You know, this example in India is just amazing, where, well, I've blogged about this recently, and I haven't got time because we've run late, and I've got to be off in 10 minutes and technology. So on the Hemingway Design blog, there's a blog about design generosity. But some of the best things that I've seen over the past decade are created on the cheap. They are generous, and they're created by very, very creative people. You know, if you haven't visited the Copenhagen Harbour Baths, then just go there. It costs £325,000 to build this. This picture can't do justice to how absolutely brilliant this is, and what an amazing visitor attraction. Imagine doing an amazing visitor attraction for £325,000. Who could do that? Only us. Only the creative industries and creative minds could do that. Who could cut through the idea that you can? This is a canal in Copenhagen. This is not clean water. Well, to me, a canal doesn't worry me, but to health and safety people, this is not clean water. This is the same water that big ships go in to get to the docks down there. But yet, thousands of people swim in it on a sign-up at their own risks. If you look at the story of how that got to be built, it got to be built by people like us. They cut through the crap. We have to cut through that crap. We're the ones who can talk common sense. We're the ones who can tell health and safety expert, you're a dick. What you're saying is totally wrong. We'll put this sign up. And we spend all our time doing that. And because there are only us that can do it. This is just a wonderful thing in Magdeburg Library in Germany. It's in a suburban area, and it's a free library. Just inside, well, in all of those little cubby holes and inside there are just books. It's open 24 hours, open to the elements, apart from there's a roof on it, so the books don't get wet. And you just go in, you take a book, and when you finish with it, you take it back. Is that the future? It's got to be. That does everything that this government wants us to do. It cuts down on cost. It's the big society. But is it happening over here? It's not. I'm finding very few examples of this over here, but it ticks every box that we're supposed to be doing. Again, we're going to have to make it work. The government have failed at doing what they said they were going to do. They, you know, would they fund this? I don't know. We're the only ones who are going to persuade them to do it. And locally, I was just trying to think, what's locally but generosity? If anybody here, we're not a million miles from Blackpool. Those that come from the south, if you do get the chance tonight and catch a later train home, go and see the Comedy Carpet in Blackpool, which is an amazing example of generous design. Last weekend, we went to see. This is something I'll leave you to look at. We'd heard about this hotel in. We'd never heard of this place called Rovinj in Croatia. Amazing. Beautiful. It's like 1/4-hour flight from here and then a short car ride into this place called Rovinj. Just unbelievably beautiful place. No English people there, just Germans and Italians there. And we'd heard about this hotel, which was Croatia's first 5-star design. You know, these things called design hotels, which can be, when you get to them, you know, sometimes you think, oh, God. But we'd heard that this was good, and we'd been on TripAdvisor, and you know there was so many good comments about it. But what excited us was this was a project that had been funded by a tobacco company who own lots of Rovinj, and obviously sales are dipping. They've got a few issues. Like they still smoke a bit more over there than we do, but they wanted to put their money into something new. And what they decided to do was employ a group of Croatian-only designers and architects and allow them complete freedom to do what they would like. And so I thought, once I'd read that, I thought, bloody hell, I better go and see it. Go and see it. It's absolutely bloody brilliant. You know, you can't really see how good it is on the website, but you know, we could be doing things like that. Why aren't we doing a Lancashire hotel that nobody touches it apart from creative Lancashire people? We can do that. You know, there's so much we could do if we just can cut through and show people examples of what happens when you let creativity, run free.